Hello and welcome to the Business Roundup for this week. My name is Vaindak Sasia, and so much is happening in the world of business, including the president rallying the African continent to focus on value addition when it comes to coffee. But that is not all, so let's dive in. Thank you, Moses, for making time to be a part of the Business Roundup. Let's start off with the World Bank that is cutting back funding because of the legislation in Uganda they don't exactly agree with. What are some of the implications of this cutting back on the funding, and what is the future looking like when you consider this?
Right. First of all, already as a country, we were having a very big challenge of soaring public debt and actually increasingly debt payment was increasingly taking the biggest portion of the national budget. Our public debt, which is now currently about 86 trillion, was partly because government had increasingly resorted to going for commercial loans, which are very expensive. So when we have a concessional lender like World Bank, who lends at a very low interest rate with a long grace period and with some grants, certainly it's a very unfortunate incident, and it can worsen the situation we are in, because already the government was financially constrained. About 3 weeks ago, you must have seen some new directives that were given by the Minister of Finance, like stopping further recruitments by all government entities, stopping travels abroad, and so many other measures which were meant to salvage the situation. So when that the World Bank cuts funding, because I remember when they were reading the national budget, a lot of funding was to come from World Bank. I remember there was about more than $600 million, which was for roads in Greater Kampala. About 2.2 trillion was to come from World Bank. There was another more than $500 million, which was for the health sector, for the lower health center, threes, fours. That money was also to come from World Bank, and so many other credit facilities. And that is why I think I remember yesterday when the state minister for finance was in parliament, Henry Musasizi. He said they will have to recall the budget and restructure it. Of course, that means they are going to cut budgets for different entities. It has so many implications. So I don't know what we are going to do as a country, but certainly no one can claim that it is not going to affect, because already, like you see what the State Minister for Finance said, already the negative impact is there. It is going to greatly affect our service delivery, but certainly the government will be compelled to reduce. We have a lot of wasteful expenditures in our national budget, and I am sure this will compel government to make some long overdue radical reforms, when you see there's so many administrative units that have been created, we have so many local governments that have been created, and these are just cost centers, by the way, because more than 80% of the money going to these local governments, small units that have been created, is going into recurrent expenditures. 65% of it is going into paying wages.
All right, I hear that, but I do believe that not all is lost. Uganda is a sovereign state, so there has to be other solutions that we can, you know, turn to in a state that we are in with the World Bank cutting back funding. And what are those? Also, what are some of the areas where we can reduce expenditure to be able to have this money back doing other things?
Okay, so when you look at the size of the cabinet, 83 ministers, we don't need all those ministers. The size of our cabinet can be cut by half. When you look at the size of our parliament, close to 600 MPs, we don't need all those MPs. Many parliaments around in the region have about 200 MPs, 150 MPs. When you look at the number of presidential advisors that we have, that even never meet the president to advise him, when you look at RDCs, why should we have RDCs when we have police and many other security organs? we the president has cows, he appoints cows to represent him in local governments. Why should we have RDCs? Look at PDM. Government has had to recruit about, because we have 10,595 parishes. So government has recruited 10,595 parish chiefs to sit in offices and put on ties to manage the PDM project. Many people think we do not need those administrative units. In fact, one of the areas where government can get money to fill the gaps created is the money for PDM. That PDM project is a pipe dream. It cannot work because, like I have told you, all those parishes that we have in the country, and you're going to spend on parish chiefs and many other administrative costs. If that money, which is more than a trillion, that project can be stopped. Part of the money can actually, we can get 50 billions for coffee seedlings, because government had initially earmarked 50 billions every year for distributing coffee seedlings, but that stopped. The money is no longer there. It was not provided in the budget, and yet this is a leading foreign exchange earner for the country. Part of that money can be used to buy tractors to boost volumes of production for agricultural produce, and you don't need a lot of money to buy tractors. You like 100 billions can do, and then the balance can be used on other pressing needs for the country.
All right, Moses, thank you so much for making time, and I believe that as a country we have a lot under our sleeves in terms of solutions for whatever we are facing with the World Bank cutting back funding and also adding value to our coffee. Until next time, thank you. Thank you, dear viewer, for making time to watch the Business Roundup, and that's it for today. Until next time,